All right, Dennis, so what do you think about the first film, Badass, that has spawned this franchise?
Well, you know what? The first film was a lot of fun to do. It did really, really well, you know, Redbox and YouTube. And it's funny, I got a lot more acclaim for Badass than I have any other film. I was in London, and a cab driver was, you know, usually it's like, hey, you know, we saw Machete, you know, it was like just crazy. It was like, Badass, hey. When we were in front of the palace, looking at Buckingham Palace, you know, and all these people wanted, you know, hey, you're that Badass guy. And I was like, wow, you know, it's kind of cool.
Where are you going with the story in Badasses?
Badasses, you know, Badass 2 is like it's me and Danny Glover, you know, and Danny Glover's amazing and just unbelievable, iconic guy. Even if he wasn't an actor, he'd be an iconic guy, you know, and so we're just having so much fun, and a friend of mine is killed, and me and Danny Glover are linked by where we live, you know, and so he ends up being my partner in crime.
What do you like about this character, Frank Vega?
Well, you know, the character as a character, you know, I don't really know the person that this was taken after, but Frank Vega as a person just reminds me of a guy that doesn't have a great big opinion of anything, doesn't really want to, you know, butt into people's business, but he will kick ass if he wants to. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? That kind of stuff.
What are you guys filming here today?
Today we're actually going to be hanging in a freezer because the bad guys got us. And I use a little bracelet. I don't think I should give that away. You know, that's a...
yeah, save some for the audience.
But me and Danny Glover are pretty close to death, and then we escape.
So Charles Bronson was a senior citizen in those later Death Wish films. How old is too old to kick ass?
Well, you know what? You might lose a little speed, but you never lose your right hand. So, you know, the power never goes, and as long as you can get a straight shot in, you're all right. And, you know, it's like the older you get, just the quicker you got to get it done, you know. So right now, if I get in a fight, I better have it done in the first 8 seconds, you know.
What do you like about Blu-ray and DVD as a way for fans to explore deeper into the role of making a film?
Well, you know what? It's like, I just think that now there's just so many avenues to enjoy a movie. There's so much new stuff. It's like, even in making a movie, you know, and right now, my son's producing and making a film right now. He went to Quick Start, you know, and they got money, and he's leaving for Milwaukee. You know, his name's Gilbert Trejo. He's leaving for Milwaukee. Him and a guy named Frankie Latina, are doing a film called Snapshot, you know, which I read the script, and, you know, naturally I'm in it. and I thought, wow, this is really creative, you know, with what they did.
What was it like steeping into the supervillain Bane in Young Justice, in the Young Justice video game?
Young Justice, I'm trying to remember. You know what, I've done so many of them. I the one I remember is Black Ops. I did that, and I did a boxing video. The boxing video is really funny because my son's mom has you know, we got divorced and had another child, and she was in her kitchen washing and dishes and she was hearing my voice from this other room, and she was like, what is, but I was talking, you know, and so she goes in, her son, I'm teaching him how to box on this video. She called me up and said, hey, you're still teaching my kid how to box. You know, so it's kind of fun.